Good morning, guys. How you guys doing? I apologize for not having a video for you yesterday. I actually had a really dope video for you yesterday. I spent hours researching it and then about 2 hours editing it and putting it together. And the second I posted it, it got blocked. And I'm actually contesting the block because they took it down. And the artist that took it down didn't even, it wasn't even their song. They didn't even sing it. So I don't know why they blocked it because it wasn't, I mean, they did do a version of the song probably 10 or 20 years prior to, but the artist that I used that did the song, I even checked the copyright and they had no copyright. They basically said anybody can use it. So I'm contesting that copyright right now. They're saying I'll have a decision by January 3rd. So maybe by the beginning of January, you'll get to see that dope ass video, but not anytime soon. But today, I have another really great song. I'm gonna let you know right now that at the time it was written, it was highly controversial, and the lyrics may incite some people today or be a little controversial today for the same reason. It's about race. But it's written about race for a reason. It was written during the civil rights era or movement. And there was all kinds of discrimination and race problems back then, and I have a feeling, my feeling is that those types of things are coming back now. So anyway, just a quick history on the song. The song is called Society's Child, or Baby, I've Been Thinking. It was actually it was written and composed and recorded originally by Janice Ian, and she originally called it Baby, I've Been Thinking, but her label and management and everything changed it to Society's Child. So it's the way it's kind of written now is Society's Child, and then in parentheses, Baby, I've Been Thinking. The lyrics are kind of centered around the taboo subject of interracial dating, which at the time the song was actually released, which was in '65, it was still a really kind of big deal. She was from like a She was from New Jersey. Where in New Jersey? Oh, East Orange, New Jersey, which was predominantly African and Native. I hate saying it. Can I just say black? It was a predominantly black neighborhood. She was one of the few white families there, but there was still kind of this racial tension of, the white family's fear of their daughters or sons dating, the black kids, and then the black families having this fear of their kids dating, white boys or girls. And this is New Jersey, people. We're not talking about Mississippi or Louisiana. Up north, we still had, there were issues. And this is in '65 too, which is kind of crazy. But she, the other crazy part is she actually wrote the song at 13, and or started, came up with the concept at age 13, and she completed writing the song at age 14. And she wrote the song because she herself was in an interracial relationship, and she saw the kind of she witnessed like the humiliation and the taunts and just the things that her boyfriend had to go through in society as being a black boy in society. And then on the flip side, the social pressures and the kind of just all the crap that she was getting at school and at home and everybody and from everyone for dating a black boy. So she's writing the song from those two perspectives. So that's kind of, that's the brief history of the song. That's all I'm going to tell you about it. I can't do her singing the song. She's got an ironclad copyright on this song. Only one other group has actually covered it, and they too have an ironclad copyright. I am assuming she gave them permission to do the song, but she performed the song from the time she was a teenager up well into, you know, her 60s or whatever, and that's it. I mean, ironclad. But her copyright does say that we are allowed to play covers. Do it with me, folks. Because we're hoping this will go. Because I really think it's important that you hear this song. Because it's very important. So, we're going to go ahead and listen to Society's Child. Because this is a bomb song. This is being covered by Sasha Layton. And I think she does a really good job. Hold on. I'm having problems with my stuff right now. Here we go.
Come to my door, baby. Face is clean and shining black as night. My mother went to and to know that you look so fine. Now I could understand your tears and your shame. She called you boy instead of your name. When she wouldn't let you inside, when she turned and said, but honey, he's not our kind. She says, I can't see you anymore, baby. Can't see you anymore. Walk me down to school, baby. Everybody's acting deaf and blind until they turn and say, why don't you stick to your own kind? My teachers all laugh their smirking stares, cutting deep down in our affairs. Preachers of equality think they believe it, then why won't they just let us be? They say, I can't see you anymore, baby. Can't see you anymore. One of these days I'm gonna stop my listening, gonna raise my head up high. One of these days I'm gonna raise up my glistening wings and fly. But that day will have to wait for a while. Baby, I'm only a society's child. When we're older, things may change, but for now, this is the way they must remain. I say I can't see you anymore, baby. Can't see you anymore, no. I don't wanna see you anymore, baby.
Okay, so that was Society's Child, and you're right, I didn't give away the ending. In this particular case, she does decide to give up the relationship. You have to understand the societal pressure she was under. She was a young teenage girl, I'm sure with a father and a mother that were very demanding. You heard that they were getting it on the way to school, they were getting it at home, the two of them together. It must have been very hard for her. I'm not saying that's an excuse, but it is an important song. So just give us some thought, you know. And think about how, I want to say how so much has changed, but really think about how so much hasn't changed or changed and now it's changed back. It's so crazy. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed the song. I hope the video stays up and you guys have a great day and hey, take care of each other. Because no one else is going to.